Bitcoin is crashing. It went from as high as $58,000 to as low as $44,000. But right now there has been a slight rebound and Bitcoin is trading at about $47,000-$48,000. But the good news is that this wasn't due to any sort of black swan event or to any bad news. This was due to people simply wanting to take profit. So that's the good news. And it's also something that we needed, a correction that was long overdue. If we look at our support levels, we are way above them. On the 50-day moving average is about 40,000, way above. And if we look at the 200-day moving average at about $21,000, again, we are way above. And the reason I say this correction was needed is because we need to avoid euphoria. We are right now here somewhere in belief or the thrill phase, probably closer to thrill. But once you hit euphoria, this is when the market is over. This is when we enter the bear market. And we even saw back in 2017 when Bitcoin went from 1,000 to 20,000, a 20x, there were multiple pullbacks of 30%. It's the only way you can continue. Once we get to a point where everyone is winning, your grandfather, your grandmother, everyone is becoming rich, that is when it is time to get out. So we are not there yet. And luckily, we have these pullbacks to keep this market going. But we are clearly in this crash right now, and it is very scary, and it's very nerve-wracking. So I'm gonna tell you in this video what happened. There were two steps, actually, that caused this crash, followed by how I'm handling this situation right now, personally. And if that sounds good, make sure to smash the like button. And with that being said, let's jump into the content. Welcome aboard the Bitcoin Express. My name is Chase. Let's get to it. As mentioned in the intro, there was not any sort of black swan event or bad news that caused this crash. It was simply investors taking profit. We are clearly in a bull market. A lot of money is being made and people want to take some reward. And if we look at this chart of Bitcoin all exchanges net flow, it shows us how much Bitcoin is being deposited onto exchanges and how much Bitcoin is being taken off exchanges. And this is a very important on-chain metric to follow. And this is something I do want to say is an advantage of crypto. We don't just rely on technical analysis from the past, but because this is the blockchain and it is open, we have on-chain data in real time. So what this chart shows is that when Bitcoin is removed from exchanges, there is less liquidity. There is less Bitcoin to trade. So there is high demand and low supply. So what happens? The price of Bitcoin goes up. Now, on the opposite, when Bitcoin is deposited onto exchanges, there is a lot of liquidity and this supply outweighs the demand and then the price dips or it crashes. So we can see on February 21st, there was a major inflow of Bitcoin onto exchanges. If you can see this huge candle over here. And of course, it was sold off and the price of Bitcoin crashed. But this was only half of the crash. The second half was due to 5.64 billion liquidated in 24 hours. And this was Bitcoin liquidated from margin accounts. These are accounts where people can take out leverage positions, which I'm going to explain to you in this video. I'm gonna let you know exactly how it works. And as this article states, this was due to more than 2,700 Bitcoin transferred right before the drop, which were bigger than the 2,000 Bitcoin inflows seen before the March of 2020 crash. So as I mentioned just a second ago, when people are depositing onto exchanges, we start to see the price drop, and then it was followed up by this forced liquidation. And then let me show you how this works. A quick disclaimer, margin trading is very risky, and it's not something that we speak about on this channel often because we try to avoid risk here. And anyone that wants to participate in margin trading probably should be an experienced trader. With that being said, let me show you how this works. So with regular accounts, a cash account, you simply deposit your money. Let's say you put in $1,000. You have $1,000 to trade. Let's say Bitcoin goes up by 10%. You made $100. So this is a regular account. Now let's look at a margin account. This is riskier. This is where you can actually borrow Bitcoin to trade, which is going on right now. People see that Bitcoin is going up, we're in a bull market, and they want to borrow Bitcoin because they think the price is going to continue going up and they're trying to maximize their profits. So when you go into a leverage position, you're taking out a loan, right? So you deposit, let's say $1,000. And if you go on 2x leverage, they'll give you another $1,000. Now you have a total of $2,000 to trade, right? So now in this case, if Bitcoin goes up by 10%, you're gonna get $200 profit. So look at the first case. Just with your own money, 10%, you get $100 profit. But here, when you're borrowing, taking out leverage, and it goes up 10%, you get $200 profit on the same increase in Bitcoin. Now, this is only a 2x leverage. You can go 5x, 10x, 50x, even 100x. But the more you borrow, the riskier it becomes. And you might be wondering, why are these platforms loaning out Bitcoin or crypto for trading? And the reason is because when it is paid back with interest. But the exchanges, these platforms, they don't just give out this money freely. There are measures in place to protect themselves. So as mentioned, you can go more than 2x, you can go 5x. So if you go 5x leverage on $1,000, you have $5,000 to trade with. If you go 20x leverage on $1,000, you have $20,000 to trade with. And as mentioned, you can go high, you can go 100x. But what happens is the higher you go, the less room you have for error. There's going to be something called the margin call. This is the price where your position will be sold off, will be liquidated. And when you take out, let's say 2x leverage, right? You're just going very small here, which I would say is still risky, right? Leverage trading even at 2x is risky. Let's say you're taking it up here. You have a lot of room for cushion. But when you take out 20x leverage, 50x leverage, you're already starting over here. You're very close to the margin call. And if you reach this position, there are only two options. Number one, you can either deposit more money as collateral, or your position will be fully liquidated. And if we look at what happened currently, these positions reach these margin calls because everyone is over leveraged right now, and these positions were liquidated. As this article states, for example, a position using 10x leverage would get liquidated or turn worthless if the price of Bitcoin drops by 5%, and this is only on 10x leverage. And we have people out here that are so bullish, we're in this bull market, they're taking out more than 10x leverage, 20x, 50x, 100x. So everyone is over leveraged right now, and all of these positions were liquidated. So this isn't something that was due to a black swan event or bad news. This was something that we have seen many times in the past, and we will likely see in the future. Even in bull markets, investors will take profits, and there always will be people that are over leveraged that will be forced out of their positions. So how am I handling this situation personally? Let me tell you. So the markets are crashing. What did I do today? I did what I always do. I continue to buy small amounts of crypto, dollar cost average. And I only say this as a long-term investor. If I was in it for the short term and I need this money ASAP, I actually would be a little nervous right now. I would be cautious, but this is not the way I treat crypto. I do have a portion of crypto that I am planning on selling in the short term, but for the most part, most of my crypto is long-term. And when I say long-term, I mean 5 to 10 years minimum. And I even have a portion that I'm never going to sell. And you might be asking, that doesn't make any sense. How are you never going to sell your Bitcoin if you ever want to see any gains from it, which I will explain to you in just a moment. Now, with dollar cost averaging, I'm avoiding putting in a lump sum and avoiding getting wrecked by any of these major crashes. If I went in with a lump sum yesterday or 2 days ago, I would be down right now big time, but I do small amounts for a long period of time. And when we look at the Bitcoin chart specifically, we can see over the last 5 days, it is clearly crashing. But when in doubt, zoom out. If we look at the 3 month chart, we are clearly in a bull market. Look at this thing, it's just going straight up. Let's look at 1 year. Bitcoin is in a bull market. And as mentioned in the first quarter of this video in the intro, even in bull markets, we are always going to have drops, especially in bear markets, we're definitely gonna have major drops. And I've said numerous times on my videos that when buying Bitcoin specifically, or some other cryptos as well, assume the day that you bought it, it is down 30% for the short term. The day that you buy crypto, you already lost 30%. But in the long term, as I said, zoom out. We are in this bull market, and this is where it really gets crazy. Let's look at the 5 year chart. This is 2017, 2018 bull market. We went from 1,000 to 20,000, all the way back down to 3,000. And everyone thought the market was over. But now when we look at this chart in the long term, this is just a little dip in the road. And here we are today. So when I say waiting a long time, I actually mean it. This was 3 years from from 2017 to where we are today. So you do have to wait a while, 3-4 years sometimes. So if you're in the short term, be very cautious. Now, getting back to what I said just a second ago, is I have a portion of Bitcoin that I'm never going to sell. How does this make sense? And I want to show you through a meme, because this is really the power now of spreading information. It's really through memes. This is from The Matrix, and it's Neo asking, "What are you trying to tell me? That I can trade my Bitcoin for millions someday?" And Morpheus answers, "No, Neo. I'm trying to tell you that when you're ready, you won't have to." Because if Bitcoin continues to grow as expected, it will be the money. It won't need to be exchanged for fiat dollars. And even today, in 2021, people are willing to accept Bitcoin. You can use it to purchase cars. You can use it to purchase a house, depending on who the seller is. We even see that Tesla has stated they are planning to accept Bitcoin for payments. But over time, as Bitcoin grows, if it grows, remember, if this thing does just crash and go to zero, then obviously this won't be the case. But as long as this price grows over time, and what I mean by over time is 5, 10, 20 years, eventually it will get to a point where you won't need to exchange your Bitcoin. The Bitcoin itself will be the money. So short-term traders out there, I'm not going to lie to you. This is a time you do want to be cautious. For long-term traders, 5, 10 years, some of us forever, this is just a small dip in the road ahead. Like this video, subscribe to the channel. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you next time.